Hello students, so I welcome you all to the session. In this session I will be discussing your FMG exam questions, the exam which was held on 4th of December. So all the FM questions we'll be discussing. So before the start of the session, let me give you a briefing about the Unacademy NEET PG segment, where daily live classes are conducted by top class educators and all the courses are structured courses. Then you get live tests also along with your subscription for live classes and recorded classes, and you have unlimited access for the duration of subscription, unlimited access to all the live classes as well as the recorded content of the live classes if at all you miss a live class. Then batch courses are held from time to time targeting different exams like NEET PG exams, INICT exams as well as FMG exams. Then there is an iconic subscription which combines the best of Unacademy and the recorded content of PrepLab. Then a subscriber also gets daily T20 is your free live test, and this is a free live test which can be attended by any student targeting your NEET PG 2021 as well as NEET PG 2022 exams. Then about free live classes, I will be informing you all in my Telegram group and the Unacademy NEET PG Telegram group for the month once it is fully finalized. Okay. Then how to download the Unacademy Learning app. So this is what you need to search in your Play Store. It is available on both Android as well as iOS. Then after installing it, go to NEET PG segment, and then for a subscription you will get these two options: either you want only the Unacademy Plus courses or the iconic subscription which combines Unacademy live courses and recorded content as well as the recorded content of PrepLab. So depending on your need, you can select whether Plus or Iconic. Then duration is to be selected by the subscriber. Then you can apply this referral code FMT10 to get a 10% discount on any duration of subscription, and done. So let us now start with FMG November 2022 recall questions. Actually it's December 2020 because the exam was held on 4th of December. So this was one of the questions. Which of the following produces catecholamine storm as seen with scorpion sting? So basically, scorpion venom acts, which other venom acts in a similar manner as of scorpion venom? That was the question. So scorpion and spiders, they belong to the same family. Correct answer is spider. Why the answer is spider? Because this is a complete family called venomous arachnids, where your scorpions and arania means spiders are classified. And these are the exact lines from Oxford Book of Toxicology is there, which is a reference book. So these are the exact lines. Spider venoms capable of harming humans fall into same two broad groupings as scorpion venoms. Now what is the common thing in a spider venom and scorpion venom? They both lead to excitatory neurotoxicity, means they are neurotoxins. And basically, which type of neurotoxins? Excitatory. As well as they also lead to locally necrotic cytotoxicity. So this is the common thing, common between scorpion and spiders. So that was your question. Now what about other options? These other options, let us see one by one. Coming to tick venom acts presynaptically and it is a neurotoxin. This is also a neurotoxin, but the difference is in excitatory component, because the scorpion venom acts on sympathetic as well as parasympathetic systems. So that is why it produces catecholamine storm, and same is with spiders. So here the mechanism is common. Now coming to sea urchins. What are sea urchins? They occur worldwide and most injuries occur due to their spines. most injuries in the form of puncture wounds. They will occur due to the spines of the sea urchins. And here the spines are non-venomous. So obviously they cannot be similar to scorpion venom. Coming to another option, which was with a C alphabet. So most likely I thought that it should be Ciguatera. Many students said that it was something like caterpillar or something like that. Whatever may be the option, suppose Ciguatera was the one of the options. Now what is Ciguatera? You should be very clear. This is the commonest marine poisoning, endemic to Indo-Pacific as well as Caribbean. Now what is Ciguatera is? It occurs, it is a constellation of symptoms which occurs due to accumulated toxins by consumption of tropical reef fish. Okay, so this is the fish. If contaminated by toxins and if a person is consuming these contaminated or these fishes, reef fishes having high levels of toxins, they will have a constellation of symptoms called as Ciguatera. So these were your four options. I hope it is clear. So the correct answer is spider. Now come to next one. An image based question was given to you where they showed you a single fruit having long spines over the surface of the fruit. So obviously this is called, commonly called thorn apple. And the scientific name is Dhatura. This is Dhatura fruit. Now Dhatura fruit, what is the active principle? That was the exact question. The toxin extracted from the poisonous plant. So the active principle of Dhatura is atropine, hyoscine, hyoscyamine. So yes, B option will be the correct answer. Conine is the active principle of conium poison. Conium poison. What is thebaine? You all must be knowing. Morphine, codeine and thebaine, MCT. These are your natural opioids. These are your natural group of opioids. Morphine, codeine and thebaine. Now what is tetrahydrocannabinol? That also you should remember, THC. Delta 9 THC is the active principle of cannabis, from which bhang, charas and ganja is extracted. So yes, the correct answer is hyoscine. Other active principles of Dhatura are atropine and hyoscyamine. Next one. This one was also a simple question. A cricketer got hit by a ball and fainted. So he got hit by cricket ball and he fainted. After some time, he regained consciousness and again fainted. So the story was like this. The person was unconscious. Then he regained his consciousness and again became unconscious. Now, what is this phenomena associated with? What is this phenomena called? This period of consciousness between two unconscious phases is called as lucid interval. And lucid interval is mostly associated with which intracranial hemorrhage? Yes, the correct answer is A, EDH. Can be associated in some cases of SDH also. But here the question is mostly associated with. So yes, most common association of lucid interval is with EDH. Along with EDH also remember always insanity. In insanity, what is lucid interval? The period of normalcy between two insane phases. Okay. Next one. This one was a beautiful question. A person got agitated and fainted. And finally, he became totally unconscious. He lost his consciousness at the airport. Some story was given like this. Now, when search was done, a bag full of enema and laxatives was recovered from him. Now, during treatment, his X-ray abdomen was done and it showed a picture as shown. So, the picture was an image of X-ray abdomen was shown to you with multiple radio opacities in the abdomen and pelvis X-ray. All of the following is true in this scenario except. Now suppose you don't know anything about this question. This was a logical question. A person got unconscious and he fainted. Obviously this person is not malingering. A bag full of enema and laxatives was recovered. During treatment, X-ray abdomen showed some findings. It was not okay. So obviously the person is not malingering. Something is there inside his abdomen and pelvis. What can be that something? That something can be drug sachets which he has consumed. So suppose a person has consumed drug sachets. Why a person will consume? So as to transport the drugs, because transport of illicit drugs is a punishable offense. So this entity is called body packer syndrome. So across countries, what people do? They consume drug sachets, drug packages, and then when they reach their destination, they use the enemas and laxatives to push them out from their body and to hand it over to the drug peddler. So this whole syndrome is called body packer syndrome. Now, why this person got unconscious? Because one of the packets might have ruptured. So the person might be under some drug effect. So that is why the person was unconscious. So yes, he is at risk of poisoning. This is also correct. Is abdominal scan indicated? Yes, you will go ahead with CT scan to look for any hemorrhages which might have occurred. CT is very good to catch hemorrhages. So CT scanning can be done, then your urine examination will be done, blood examination will be done further to look for the type and quality of the drug which the person has consumed. So all of the following is true in this scenario except, yes, the person is not malingering. So this one will be the wrong option. Now, this is how the packages, drug packages look like. They are wrapped in latex coatings. Like your cocaine, heroin, they are wrapped in latex coatings and the person consumes these tablets. So the picture of abdomen will be, yes, these tablets will be visible. Now, in these, this is a X-ray image and this is the CT image, where again, tablets can be seen. Okay. Now you can see these black arrows are pointing towards that these packages are arranged in parallel. What is this sign called? This sign is called parallelism. There are some radiological signs in body packer syndrome. One sign is parallelism sign, where the packages are arranged in parallel stacks. Then you can see a translucent rim where this white arrow is pointing. You can see a translucent rim. What is this called? In this image also you can see. You can see a translucent rim. So if you get a translucent rim separating the inner core, that is called double condom sign. Double condom sign. And what is this box representing? This box is showing you that these packages are in multiple numbers and arranged at one place. So there is a sign called tic-tac sign, which is also evident on radiology. Tic-tac, you all must be knowing, tic-tac is your mint tablets. So in the shape of oblong mint tablets, you get oblong radio opacities on X-ray clubbed together, so called as tic-tac. So these are your three important signs in cases of body packer syndrome. These can be your upcoming questions. Next one. A dead fetus was found in water canal. The crown hill length was given something around 25 centimeter. Distinct fingernails visible with minimal hair growth. Approximate age of the fetus was asked to you. So whenever crown hill length is given, you can apply your Hassie's rule. Hassie's rule and Morrison's rule is there. Hassie's rule says for first 5 months of pregnancy, if you do square root of crown heel length, this will give you age of the fetus in months. And this crown hill length is to be taken in centimeters. So that was the question. 25 centimeter square root is 5. So answer will be 5 months. Now Morrison's rule is applicable for next 5 months of pregnancy. And this says, if you divide crown heel length in centimeters by 5, you will again get the age of the fetus in months. So these are your two important rules for age estimation of dead fetus. The question was about that. Okay. So correct answer is 5 months. Now fingernails reach the tip of fingers. Fingernails development start by 3rd month, but they reach the tip of the fingers by 8 months. So yes, fingernails are visible means early development of fingernails has occurred. So again, it correlates. And minimal hair growth like your laryngeal hairs, they are evident by about 5th month. Yes, 5th to 6th month. Your vernix caseosa, the cheesy material to protect the fetus from amniotic fluid exposure. You get a cheesy material called vernix caseosa that appears at around 4 to 5 months. Your laryngeal hairs, they provide the strength to the fetal skin. So that also appears at about 5 to 6 months. So everything correlates with the question. So the correct answer is 5 months. Next one. Gender assessment in a 12-year-old child is best done by. So assessment of gender from skeletal remains. We have a sexual accuracy table. What is this accuracy table telling us? That which bones will have how much accuracy? So according to this accuracy table given by Krogmans, called as Krogmans table, all 206 bones, if police has brought all 206 bones to the doctor, your accuracy will be 100%. If you have pelvis and skull, your accuracy is 98%. If you have only pelvis, your accuracy is 95%. If you have only skull bone, your accuracy decreases to 92%. So the question was about this Krogmans accuracy table. So according to this, pelvis comes out to be the best answer. So yes, here hip will be the best answer. Okay. Next one. In pelvis also, which is that parameter in the hip bone? Which is that parameter which is best? Overall, pelvis is the best bone. Hip bone is the best bone. In pelvis also, greater sciatic notch. Always remember this. This I have been telling in all my classes. Greater sciatic notch is the ideal parameter. This can be your upcoming question. Overall, pelvis is best. In pelvis, that is your hip bone. Which parameter is best? Greater sciatic notch to assess the gender of a child. Next one. This one was again a simple question. A gunshot case brought for autopsy shows an entry wound with inverted margins. So yes, this is the natural rule. In entry wound, the margins of the skin will show you inversion. Along with the inverted margins, the wound was surrounded by tattooing. This was given as told by students only. Then burning and singeing of hairs is not noted. This was clearly mentioned. What is the range of firearm weapon? The correct answer here goes with near shot. Near means medium range, or I can say intermediate. So what happens in intermediate shot? You get a entry wound. Along with this entry wound, you can get tattooing plus minus blackening. So whenever tattooing is present, yes, the range of the firearm weapon has to be intermediate shot. That was the simple question. This I have told you in classes. I will not be discussing the range of firearm weapon topic. That is a bigger topic. But yes, the answer will be intermediate, medium range or near shot. In contact, the entry wound will be star shaped. That was not given in the question. Plus singeing is absent. So in contact shot, everything goes inside the wound, your flame effect, smoke effect and particles effect, unburnt gunpowder particles effect. That means singeing, blackening, and tattooing. So it cannot be contact shot. Why it can't be distant shot? None of the effects are visible in distant shot. No effects. Which effects? Singeing, blackening, and tattooing. But here tattooing was present. So yes, distant cannot be the answer. And 2 meter is about 200 centimeter. So 200 centimeter is also going to be distant shot. For almost all weapons, your short barrel rifle weapons, long barrel rifle weapons, as well as shotgun. Remember the table which I have told you in classes? You got one question from that table. So range of the firearm weapon estimation, range of estimation is a very important topic, and you got one question. And this one was a simple question. By ruling out options also, you can solve the question. Next one. Which IPC section is related to medical negligence? This one was the simplest question. Correct answer is 304A. So which are the IPC sections related to negligence? 36, 337, 338, and 304A. Because all these sections of IPCs, they say a negligent act has endangered life of a person. Endangering life. Now the FIR is lost under 336. 37 says, when due to negligent act, hurt has occurred to a person, simple injury, or hurt has occurred. 38 says, when due to negligent act, grievous hurt has occurred to a person, FIR will be lost under 38. And 304A says, whenever due to negligent act, death of a person has occurred. This I have told you time and again in all my classes. And you got one simple question. Other way around, this question can be asked like this. All of the following sections are related to negligent act except. So you should remember, all these four sections are related to negligent act. So obviously it will be applicable to medical negligence also. Usually which cases are registered under 304A IPC? All your road traffic accidents, RTA cases. Because road traffic accidents occur due to negligent act of the driver. So the driver name is booked in the FIR under which IPC? 304A. This question can be asked like this also. Okay, so simple question. What is 300 IPC? 300 defines murder. This defines murder. 302 defines the punishment for murder. And what is 304B IPC? This defines dowry death and its punishment. Suppose you were aware of these three IPCs. Obviously, by ruling out options also, you can solve it. Now come to next one. This one was also a simple question. Lollipop question. A female after 4 years of marriage died, and one note was recovered from her mentioning that she was tortured for dowry. Before death, obviously, she might have written a note. In this case, inquest will be done by. Whenever death of a married female occurs within 7 years of marriage, and if it is proved that just before her death there was demand for dowry or torture for dowry either by husband or any relative of the husband, then the case becomes a case of dowry death, a punishable offense under 304B IPC. But the question was, inquest will be done by which authority? So here the inquest is done under 176 CRPC. And here the inquest is done by a magistrate. Simple question. Okay. Police inquest comes under 174 CRPC. Okay. This one was also a practical based question. A case of road traffic accident, RTA means road traffic accident, was brought for autopsy. Stiff neck, hands, and both upper and lower limbs were noted. What is this suggestive of? A sort of this recall was told by many students. Okay, the exact lines might be different. I will tell you. Now, suppose a road traffic accident has occurred, and you are seeing stiffness even in hands. Hands means your fingers. So in a RTA case, if stiffness is involving your fingers and lower limbs, Obviously, this is contraction of the muscles, and contraction of muscles after death is called as rigor mortis. Okay. Had the question been a case of RTA was brought for autopsy, the person was struggling at the time of death, and when police reached the spot, they saw the hand muscles in contractile state. Just this thing was mentioned. So yes, now it goes with cadaveric spasm. Okay. What is cadaveric spasm? Loss of ATPs in one group of muscles at the time of somatic death. So that is why cadaveric spasm cannot be the answer. Okay. Because here the contraction is in almost whole body. And the last part to go into contraction is fingers and toes. So by giving hands, the examiner told you that contraction has started from your upper body part and it has developed in whole body. So obviously the answer will be rigor mortis and never cadaveric spasm. Okay. Now come to this one. A female faked pregnancy and presented a real child to blackmail a guy. This one was an interesting question. Which is correct about this case? Okay. So what is this child called, which a female is faking pregnancy and now she has brought a child to blackmail a guy that this is your son? What is correct about this case? This child is called supposititious child, also called as fictitious child. Another name word used is fictitious. Now your upcoming questions will be from these two areas. So let me cover this area. Okay. Now these are two cases. One is affiliation case and one is supposititious child. To be easily differentiated, can be easily differentiated. In both the scenarios, a child is brought by the mother. Okay. In both the situations, child is brought by the mother. And the alleged father denies being the father in both the situations. But where lies the difference? In the affiliation cases, the relief is sought by mother for maintenance of the child. This is the motive, that the expenses for bearing of child bearing should be given by the father. This is the intention of the mother here. But what is the intention of the mother in a supposititious child? Money, marriage, property, blackmailing. Now, if the female is assessed and the child is assessed, in the female, if she is true, she will show you signs of pregnancy and delivery. And those signs will be present and will be compatible with the child's age. But what is the scenario in supposititious child? She has brought a child from somewhere. She might have stolen a child from temple or some other place. So here the signs of pregnancy and delivery will not be present because she has faked the pregnancy. If at all present, then it will be incompatible with child's age. This is how you can easily differentiate. Now, what is the legal outcome of affiliation cases? Legal outcome is, if in the first case, the female is found to be true and when paternity testing was done by blood grouping and by DNA fingerprinting, it was found that the father, alleged father, is the true father based on DNA analysis. Okay. So now the maintenance for bearing, child bearing, the money component will be awarded by the first class judicial magistrate. Under which law? Under 125 CRPC. So these are your potential questions. Which magistrate can look over this case? Answer is first class. Under which law? Under 125 CRPC. Now what happens in supposititious child is, the child is returned to the original parents because the child was a stolen child. And the female, what happens to this female who has presented a fictitious child? The female is punished for cheating or fraud. Okay. So remember this important topic, because they have explored a new topic. So they can ask you questions based on affiliation case and supposititious child in further exams. I hope it is clear. Okay. Affiliation is a true case where the father is a true father, but he is denying to be the father. So now it will be proved by DNA analysis, blood grouping and all. And finally, the money for maintenance of the child will be awarded by the first class judicial magistrate and he has to do it. This was another question. This question is little bit incompletely framed. Okay. So it is not fully recalled, but whatever pieces I could get, let us discuss those pieces. The question was something like this. A person was found dead in bushes with tied arms. So obviously no one will commit suicide by tying his arms. This thing is very clear. Now, cyanosis of nails were noted, signifying asphyxial deaths. With scratches over face, neck and chin. See the areas where scratches means scratch abrasions are present. And I have told you in classes that scratch abrasions can be produced by pins, needles as well as fingernails. Okay. So fingernail scratch abrasions over face, over neck, over chin is suggestive of manual strangulation, also called as throttling. And yes, some findings, some students told that there was also given that abrasions are present over inner side of lips. So there might be an attempt of smothering also. So whatever may be the case, let us try to understand this topic. If you are given a dead body where abrasions are present over inner side of lips, scratch abrasions are present over front of neck, chin and face. This is highly suggestive of homicidal attempt. Okay. So the question was something like this. All of the following is correct in this case, except. So yes, this is the case of homicide. It is suggestive of asphyxial death. And most likely the case can be a case of throttling or a smothering. So it cannot be a case of suicide. So this one will be your correct answer. Okay. Most likely the question was like this. Whatever may be the lines of the question, now you can make out the correct answer. This one was finally asked, which I predicted that you will get one question from the trace evidence topic, and finally you got one, the simple one. Stains over clothes. And they asked the question like this. The method with which I teach you this topic, the question was presented like that. I teach you na white stains and red stains. So the word of the question was also stains over clothes when examined. Then they showed yellow color needle shaped crystals, and obviously crystals will be examined under microscope. So what can be this stain? Obviously this one will be a white stain, and this white stain we need to confirm whether it is semen or not. And which test give you this result? Yellow color needle shaped crystals is achieved in Barbarius test. So yes, the correct answer will be semen sample. Okay. Simple question. So these were the questions of your FMG exams. So thank you everyone. Bye bye.